I'd like to begin today by inviting Elder Carolyn Moore to come up and offer an opening prayer and to open this occasion in a good way.
Hello? Can you hear me? It's very dangerous putting a mic in front of me. I might start singing Patsy Cline. It's such an honor to be here this morning because I'm part of this program that we're funding. I'm one of the facilitators and my co-facilitator here, Jolene Wilson. And we've had our first graduation. And from the comments, they really enjoyed it, but I'm also praying that it's very helpful. And that's what's important. So I'm going to open this up with a prayer, and I want to say a big miigwech to the ones that are funding us, and to know that we can help many more people that are suffering right now. So miigwech. Creator, it's blue sky woman, morning star from the Deer Clan. Oh, Creator, you brought us today on such a beautiful day with the rain doing the cleansing. Please walk with us, help this funding, and help the ones that are giving us to walk with wisdom and walk with all that's on their heart. Help us, Creator, help us to help others and walk with us always. Keep our journey safe. Ho-ho, miigwech, all my relations. Miigwech, thank you.
Thank you, Carolyn. We're honored to have you here today. It is my great pleasure to now introduce a woman who has been a tireless champion of violence against women and of our center. From day one as the Minister of the Status of Women Manitoba, Minister Squires has been stepping up and speaking out to break the silence on this issue. She is a role model fighting hard to turn Me Too into Never Again. Please join me in welcoming the Honorable Rochelle Squires to the podium.
Wow, it is such an honor to be here this morning. Thank you very much, Lorie, for opening up your center and allowing us to all host this meeting here. It's an honor to be welcomed onto Treaty One territory. And I want to thank the Elder for your blessing this morning and to thank your ancestors for welcoming my ancestors to this land two centuries ago. I'm just absolutely delighted to be here this morning on behalf of our Premier Brian Pallister, along with my colleagues, Minister Stefanson, who is the Minister of Families, as well as my colleagues from Brandon, MLA Len Islefson, and MLA Reg Helwer, and excited that there is a wonderful Brandon component of this morning's announcement, and we're really delighted to have executives from Brandon who made the way here as well. So it's such an honor to see so many faces in the room who've been part of a network of supporting women. Thrilled that the North End Women's Resource Center is here, and that's what the community of women's resource centers has become, is really women helping women all throughout our great city. And this morning, we are going to be just expanding that network and making those relationships even more solid on a go-forward basis. So our government values and recognizes the dedicated, hardworking Manitobans, and in particular, the women who work daily to end family violence. That is why we are embarking on changes to enhance the Family Violence Prevention Program in order to better serve the needs of those families experiencing violence. So I'm pleased to be here at the West Central Women's Resource Center today during Sexual Assault Awareness Month. I encourage all of us during this month to reflect on how society is changing its attitudes in regards to sexual violence, and to ask ourselves, what have we done to be part of that change? And then to consider, what else can we do? Because if we are going to change the culture and the community around sexual violence, it is going to take a collective effort, and all of us are part of that solution. We know that meaningful change requires each and every one of us to take action, supporting survivors who choose to disclose, educating ourselves and our loved ones about consent, and modeling respectful behavior. Not only are we here during the middle of Sexual Assault Awareness Month to continue the dialogue on sexual assault that is necessary to make those changes, it does give me great pleasure to be here this morning to announce that the Manitoba government will be providing $118,000 a year in annual funding to the West Central Women's Resource Centre, which will formally bring them into the Family Violence Prevention Program. This annual funding will ensure that this centre will be able to provide ongoing, important and necessary services to women and their families who have experienced violence. The West Central Women's Resource Centre is located in a critical Winnipeg neighbourhood, and that is why it is imperative that the Family Violence Prevention Programme create this long-term commitment in supporting the women and the children who reside here. We know that when we work towards supporting women, we are supporting their families and building communities. We also know that women are overwhelmingly affected by intimate partner violence and sexual violence, and when this happens, it can be difficult to find assistance. When women experience relationship violence or sexual violence, it is important that services be located right in their community and that the services be accessible and welcoming. That is what our women's resource centers do. They offer women a place where they are felt welcome, where they can walk in and meet with trained staff and be immediately connected with services and support. Since 2001, the West Central has been a well-established resource place that has developed positive relationships and community trust with local neighborhood women. This center serves on an average of 100 women a day. That is phenomenal. That is an amazing amount of work that you do each and every day, demonstrating the imperative that this centre receive stable and ongoing funding. So I would like to extend my sincerest gratitude to Executive Director Lorie English, along with all of your staff, your board members, and your volunteers that it takes to run this incredible organization, for all that you do to support women and their families in this community. Your commitment, compassion, and dedication enables women to make courageous choices in finding the path that supports the development of their family and overall their great community. I'm also pleased to announce that the Manitoba government will be providing an additional $58,000 in annual funding to the Women's Resource Centre in Brandon. The Women's Resource Centre in Brandon provides programs, services, and counseling on issues affecting women and children, including family violence, while encouraging respect, diversity and equality with a feminist perspective. So thank you for all the hard work that you do, and we're very pleased to support you in that work. Today's announcement, we recognize that will stabilize the agency and allow for a permanent executive director position to be filled at the Brandon Women's Resource Centre. This will ensure that families in Western Manitoba can access the support they need when faced with incidents of family violence. We recognize the importance of services offered by agencies like West Central and Brandon, and know that much of the good prevention work being done to address family violence is happening right here at these resource centres. They are vital resources to women, families, and the communities as a whole. So once again, I'm just so delighted to have all of you here, to be here today at the West Central Women's Resource Centre, and to bring them under the umbrella of the Family Violence Prevention Program, and to be providing that enhanced funding to the Brandon Women's Resource Centre. I look forward to our continued partnership. And again, I want to extend my deepest gratitude to everyone who works to support women and their families. And once again, during Sexual Assault Awareness Month, I want to commend everyone who has ever offered their support to women and girls who are affected by sexual violence. So thank you very much from the bottom of my heart for the work that you all do. I also want to extend a huge thank you to Executive Director Beth Ulrich of the Women's Status of Women Secretariat, and everybody at the Family Violence Prevention Program for the work that you do each and every day to support women. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. Miigwech.
Thank you, Minister Squires, for this important and crucial investment. This partnership will help to change the lives of many of the women that we work with. Gender-based violence is something that transcends identity boundaries. Women of all ethnicities, faiths, classes, ages, education levels, and backgrounds are at risk of experiencing violence. However, what we also know is that some women are more likely to experience violence than others. Manitoba's rate of violence against women is double the national average, and women who are Indigenous, living with disabilities, newcomers, or LGBT2SQ+, are disproportionately represented in these grim statistics. West Central Women's Resource Centre has been supporting women experiencing or fleeing violence from our very first day. We provide women with a safe place for them and their children, whether they need a shower, a hot meal, or simply a compassionate ear. We know that leaving violence is often a difficult and scary thing for women to do. It can mean losing everything they own, disconnection from their family and community, income and housing insecurity, and even sometimes homelessness. We value the important work done by our sister organizations, the violence against women shelters that exist throughout our province, to be that first place that's safe for women and their children when there's nowhere else for them to go. These first steps are critical ones, and these spaces are vital to women fleeing violence. The question becomes, what next? What happens after their stay in shelter is done? How do women begin to rebuild their lives? And this is the role that centers like ours can play. Women's resource centers like ours and our sister agencies like North End Women's Center, Fort Garry Women's Resource Center, and the Women's Resource Center in Brandon are places where women can come to seek connection and healing. Every day we support women who have been victims of violence, and they come to trust us and to include us on their road to recovery. This investment from the province of Manitoba will allow us to provide programs that assist women in their healing of trauma from violence and to begin to regain their confidence and rebuild their lives. Almost 10 years ago, our former colleague and friend, Shannon Buck, developed the Red Road to Healing program while she was a staff member here at the center. This 10-week innovative program provides healing from violence through Indigenous teachings. It's the only of its kind in Manitoba. It's now offered throughout the province in many organizations and has been nationally recognized as a best practice in violence recovery. In Red Road, Indigenous women reconnect to their culture and become better equipped to take their rightful place as leaders, teachers, and nurturers of the next generations. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Elder Carolyn Moore and my colleague and knowledge keeper, Jolene Wilson, who co-led Red Road to Healing programs here at the center. Women can also access a myriad of other programs here that empower them to believe in themselves, move forward, gain skills, and achieve goals that many of us take for granted, such as having a safe place to live, having a job and economic security, and having the ability to support their children. With this funding and the invitation to join the Family Violence Prevention Program, we have the ability to do more to help families that have been victims of violence. Our center will put every dollar to work to address root causes and halt the cycles of violence by using holistic, evidence-based approaches that involve diverse women, men, and youth. Today, we are announcing the launch of our Restoring the Balance program, a new multifaceted initiative to help end family violence. First, we will continue to offer Red Road to women who need it. Many women are already on the waiting list for the next round, and we know that this program is very real. Alongside this, we will offer a new groundbreaking violence recovery program for newcomer women called Healing Together. This program was adapted from the curriculum from Red Road to Healing and guided by an advisory circle of women with lived expertise and a working group of agency partners, and has been developed to be culturally relevant and inclusive of newcomer experiences and realities. We also know that intergenerational violence and trauma will never cease without the participation and healing of perpetrators of violence. Statistics show that perpetrators of violence have often also been victims themselves, and to this end, we will establish a men's healing circle that will give men an opportunity to heal their own trauma and to begin to work on being positive supports for their families and communities. Finally, our holistic approach also targets youth who have witnessed or experienced family violence through a sharing circle for parents and children together that will focus on healthy relationships and self-esteem in the hopes of breaking the cycle of violence. We can't wait to get started and are looking forward to working with many of you in this room over the coming years. On behalf of all of us at West Central Women's Resource Center and our board, we want to thank Minister Squires, Minister Stefanson, the Executive Director of the Status of Women of Manitoba, Beth Ulrich, and the staff from the Family Violence Prevention Program for their commitment, dedication, and leadership to this issue, to our center, and to women in Manitoba. Together we can work so that we all have the strength, so that all women have the strength, dignity, and love that they need to live full and healthy lives. Thank you. Next, I have the pleasure of introducing our next speaker. As Minister of Justice, Minister Heather Stefanson launched a modernization strategy focused on prevention, targeted resources, restorative justice, and reintegration, which will make a difference in the lives of many of the women that we support. We are looking forward to working with her as Minister of Families on issues such as poverty, child and family services, and childcare. I'd now like to call the Honorable Heather Stefanson to the podium.
Thank you very much, Lori, and good morning, everyone. It's an honor for me to be here this morning. Thank you, Elder Moore, for your beautiful opening prayer that really sets the stage for all of us and how we can work together towards ending family violence in our province. So I also just want to recognize Minister Squires, who works tirelessly as an advocate for women, both on the health and safety side in the Manitoba Legislature. And I know we can't do this alone. And that's why it's so important for all of us here together to work together towards the eradication of family violence. And so thank you all for being here this morning. We're working together across government departments so we can better support Manitobans who experience family violence. We're investing in programs and resources for Manitoba women and families because we want to help end the cycle of violence. These changes today will support stronger families and communities and will lead to better outcomes for Manitoba women and children. We want to welcome the West Central Women's Resource Center into the Family Violence Prevention Program. You do amazing work, including valuable childcare and housing programs. In Brandon, the Women's Resource Center will now receive dedicated funding for an executive director. These community-led centers help women build safer lives for themselves and for their children with a focus on safety, healing, and wellness. Stable, ongoing annual funding for both these centers will allow them to focus on developing and delivering crucial services for families. I'd like to recognize the staff, board of directors, and volunteers here in Brandon, for their hard work and dedication. We are beyond grateful for the tremendous work you do for women and families in our community. Thank you all so much for being here. Merci et miigwech.
Thank you, Minister Stefanson. Your support and dedication means so much to us. Indeed, the support and dedication of all of you in this room is so important. So thank you very much for coming. And at this time, I would invite media and the ministers to take any questions.